For all of our PI ProcessBook users, we have some exciting news for you. We've developed a utility to migrate over your PI ProcessBook displays over to native PI Vision displays. What that means is that all of your hard work building out all those ProcessBook displays can carry over to PI Vision. Hi, this is Jeff from OSIsoft Learning. In order to leverage the full value of PI Vision, you want to make sure that you have your displays created as native PI Vision displays. But since you've already taken the time to build out your PI ProcessBook displays, let's use the migration utility to move over all that hard work and create a display that we can edit and add to in PI Vision itself. In previous versions of PI Vision, you've been able to host these PI ProcessBook displays, but this utility will help you migrate them over fully. We'll want to make sure that we can migrate as many things as possible from our PI ProcessBook displays to PI Vision, and let's take a look and see how we can do it.
Here's what you'll need to do. First, we'll launch the migration utility, and we'll need to fill in where our PI ProcessBook displays are. You can see that we brought in our entire folder structure, so everything is kept nice and organized. We can keep the same folder structure our users had before to organize our displays. We'll get to that part in a few minutes. Next, we'll select which displays we want to run our analysis on, and determine how precisely we can migrate all of the display's objects. I'll select all of my displays to see what kind of shape I'm in to make the full upgrade to PI Vision. And I'll kick off the analysis by clicking the button at the bottom of the window. On the right side of the utility, we can see that there are two views that we can choose from to view the analysis results, the summary view and the tree view. In summary view, displays are grouped by status. The top with the green check mark show the group of displays where all objects and data items are going to move over successfully. A point of clarification here, the green check mark means that everything on the display can and will be migrated, but it may not look identical due to the formatting differences between PI ProcessBook and PI Vision. So everything will move over easily, but may not look exactly the same. We're thinking about things like fonts, or size of objects, or different colors. The tree view gives us the folder structure that we're used to seeing our displays in. We can also sort by a few columns, such as the issues column. I have to click on the little filter icon that looks like a funnel, and I'll get my sorting and filtering options. By now, you've probably noticed that there are a couple of warning icons popping up. Let's take a look at what the issues are. If you want more information on each issue symbol, you can check out the manual linked in the description below. To help you see if you're ready to move over to PI Vision, and to assess whether you're okay with losing some of the custom VBA code that might be on your ProcessBook displays, we've created a button at the bottom where you can export your VBA code for your different displays. Under View Reports, we have a few options that our info junkies can have a look at. We have the analysis report as well as the migration report. After you run the analysis on your different displays, you'll be able to see all of the different pieces that are being checked for our migration utility. In order to have a success, that analysis report is going to say that all of the data objects are going to be able to move over successfully. Up until migrating the displays, everything that you've done at this point, you could do without access to any PI Vision server and without any migration taking place. This makes the migration utility a great tool to see what state your current PI ProcessBook displays are in and what you might need to work on if you want to move over to PI Vision fully. Since in my case I'd like to finish out the migration, let's go through and see the different options that I can put in to make my migration successful. First, I'll need to connect to my PI Vision server. Next, I'll select the destination PI Vision folder where I'd like to put my displays under. I can select a display owner if I'd like at this point. And all of the display owners that are listed here are just going to be different users that have already accessed my PI Vision server. I can select my security level. And remember how I told you can keep your PI ProcessBook folder structure? Well, if I check this box of persist folder structure from migrated items, that will let me keep the same folder structure that I had in PI ProcessBook. Again, this might be really helpful for your users who are used to finding their displays in a certain place. For the duplicate file names, I can just leave this a skip, and I'll hit OK. When it's done running the migration, I can see that all of my displays were migrated successfully. Keep in mind, I had a few issues that were pointed out to me, such as different data sets or ActiveX objects that were not migrated over. This is expected, but the rest of my display was moved over successfully to PyVision. If I open up the migration report, I can see the names of the display as well as a link to access my display in my PyVision server. Let's check out a few of these displays that have been moved over. This migration utility has created a native PyVision display, which I can manipulate the same way I would any other PyVision display. I'll open up my energy management overview display, and let's take a look side by side at how it looks next to the PI ProcessBook original display. As you can see, now that it's in PyVision, I'm able to see everything that was there on the original PI ProcessBook display, and I can move it around, add, edit, change things the same way that I would with other native PyVision displays. We hope this PI ProcessBook to PyVision migration utility has really helped you get up to speed with PyVision. Let us know in the comments if you like the tool and how you're using it at your company.